The team was 57 miles away when a chunk of ice the size of Chicago calved into the ocean, revealing seafloor that had never been accessible to humans. So they monitored the ice over satellite and raced there in one day to lower a submersible robot more than 1,000 meters deep into the ocean to explore the area.
How long was it until you started seeing things that humans have never seen before?
Almost immediately. The first thing we saw was a huge sponge with a crab on it. That's already quite amazing, because one question that we had is, will there be any life at all under an ice shelf?
Sponges take a very long time to grow. To get this big, scientists say this world must have been locked away, thriving under the ice, possibly for centuries.
See, we didn't have to disturb the crinoid earlier. We got one that's swimming for us.
Everything the robot saw was simultaneously live streamed to the scientists. They're the ones talking here, and anyone else watching online.
How in the world does anything exist when there's no energy getting down there for them to eat? Where is that energy coming from?
That's one of the things that we are aiming to figure out and to study and to research from now on.
It could be ocean currents bringing in the nutrients.
For Dr. Vermani, watching back in California, it was a once-in-a-lifetime moment for science.
I know that they have found at least 6 new species confirmed, but I think there's many more yet to be analyzed.
Because Schmidt Ocean Institute makes all of its research, data, and live stream open access, this door into a new section of the ocean is now open for other scientists to explore.
The Antarctica is changing rapidly, and in order to understand what's going to happen, we really need to come back and keep studying and keep trying to learn and understand what was driving that ecosystem under the ice shelf.
They plan to return to Antarctica in 2028.